2015's FISMA's fall protests were a defining moment in the year for many students. This is equally true of the student journalists who covered it, navigating the tricky space between being embedded in the issues as a student and striving for objectivity as a journalist.
Well, with the particular protest, it was quite a hard line to tread because I have a deeply vested interest on both sides for very different reasons. As a journalist, I want to cover the story as best that I can. I want to get good photos and, you know, do my job well. But that kind of necessitates me to detach myself a little bit from the situation, which is hard when, as also a student of this university, I have a very deeply vested interest in the protests. So the way that I kind of see it is, when I'm doing my job as a journalist, I'm like journalist Josh, where it's okay, focusing now on the job at hand. What matters is the story, is the photographs. I can worry about the bigger picture and everything else later. So I think that that's what I can do for the protests, because I could just go stand with them and do that, but I feel I have more power as a journalist.
One of the early moments of controversy in the protests was the altercation between protesters and police at the East Cape Midlands College.
So East Cape Midlands is along this long road, and the police had sort of amassed themselves at one end. The police came from their side down to the protesters and started talking with some of the leaders, I guess, and after a bit of negotiating, chatting, and sort of failing of communication, I suppose, they went back to their vehicles, and 5 minutes later, stun grenades were thrown in, and the riot vehicle just started plowing down that road with the water cannon firing. And at this point, most of the protesters panicked and fled down the road, and myself and some fellow journalists who were on the side of the road taking photographs were physically thrown by the some of the officers there. And after that, we all just ran down the road as fast as we could to try and get away from this thing. Yeah, so that was a rather intense moment, and I believe that was quite early on in the protest, so hell of a start, I suppose. The most challenging moment, which kind of made me snap out of journalist mode for a little bit, was during the xenophobic looting. There was this shop which had an attempted looting, which was stopped by the police now. These people, they wanted to loot the shop, and so the police came up with a rather peculiar yet ultimately effective method to end the situation peacefully. They took some of the produce and products out of the shop and took them in front of the crowd of people that had gathered and just dumped them in a pile. And they stated, we're all going to do this in a civilized manner and yada yada, but that's not how it went down. How it went down was, as soon as all of that had gathered, the people basically just descended on it like a pack of wolves. It was quite a little bit of a sickening thing to see, and so I just kind of stopped taking photos. The whole situation of these people who've been put in this incredibly awkward and weird situation by completely messed up circumstances.
I said to you,